Social media has advanced the frontier of conventional media and redefined communication devoid of distance between people. Almost all the conventional media houses, both the print and electronics, are also on social media to feed their online followers in the wake of affordable data made possible by telecommunication service providers. The recent fake news about killings in Plateau State took people by surprise when a rejoinder was issued, an act which caused the journalist his job. Speaking to ITV News, a social media activist, Ahmed Danyaru, believed that severe punishment to promoters of hate speech, which will be a viable solution and serve a deterrent to others.
We want the government to set an example. How do they set an example? People that promote this sort of news resulting into more killings, they should be brought to book. We have enough legislations in the country. So what is next is for the government to implement those legislations and make sure that people that tempt or promote hatred among people resulting into more killings are brought to book. So the government have a very key role to play.
He cautioned Nigerians on vigilance, especially as it affects the circulation of all pictures, videos, and fake news as 2019 election is fast approaching.
And there is a great danger if that issue is not arrested. It is likely that we are going to, as we are facing the next year election, it's likely that maybe there is tendency that people are going to use fake speech and fake news in order to draw sentiment and emotions around the country. Fake images. A lot of events do happen in another country whereby somebody, because of one reason or the other, get those pictures, get those imageries, post them in social media, and that results into a reprisal attack and killings, resulting into more killings.
The National Assembly has been contemplating a bill to regulate the social media in Nigeria, an act which has faced strong resistance from major stakeholders. Al-Hassan Bala, ITV News, Abuja.